Hey, welcome to Robot Wars, the new mod. Neat stuff, we're going to try something new today. We have been working on our machine on emergency. Let's go into arcade mode. And let's see, game settings. Mayhem. Tag team. Arena. Combat. Robots. Here we go. Something really hairy. Thor. And we give them, what is Tomb? What's the game have? Okay, Tomb Raider, that looks interesting. It's Mouse Team. Okay, how about Mega Mouse? Mega Mouse. Oh, Hellfire, sorry about that. And, this Flamic, or however you pronounce that, versus Emergency. And we've done a little bit of work on Emergency. It's not a super heavyweight, this tag is incorrect. Under 80 kilograms, just barely, but under. We just did a little bit of work on the weapons pack. I noticed that the weapons were, a couple of them were turning in the wrong direction, causing the machine when it was inverted to spin. So we did a little work on that, and hopefully it's corrected. So without too much more hoorah, here we go. We'll use the F2 key to try to keep track of all the action. Two versus one, two super heavyweights versus one heavyweight. And I don't expect to win this, but this is a pretty good machine, so let's get started and see how Emergency performs in a 2-to-1 match. Outgunned, outweighed, but it's a very good machine. So here we go.
Enter the combat zone. Everyone hold on to your seats. This match is going to blow you away. The saws and spikes are especially sharp. I've never felt such a cold chill as I've felt between the opposing bots this evening.
Three, two, one.
Poke all these robots!
That was something. Okay, just for fun, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the machine itself. And so there's no questions here. Let's go to parts. And you can see just under 80 kilograms, heavyweight. And panic attack lid, motorcycle wheels. These little itty bitty cargo. These teeth, once you put them on, they're really almost impossible to get them back off. Anyway, we have carbon fiber extenders and our amp blade, using amp blade to mount this right here, the overdrive disc. Do the same thing with these amp blades here. They also, if the disc gets broke off, you still have the amp blade as a secondary weapon. Not much, but it's something. And for the drive wheels, we use the NTM brushless motors. The chassis is made of titanium. We have two of these batteries here, and one receiver, small receiver, and that's pretty much it. You see the weapons pack here, these guys, inertia style disc and teeth, and we have this big wedge in here, and there, of course, in reality would be a couple of holes slicing right here for the spinners to work through, but that's no big deal. It's fairly realistic, almost completely. You see here, we mounted the fiberglass extender and these carbon extenders. Use this little guy right here, the mega adapter, to mount those on. And I'm still thinking of changing these out to maybe conserve some weight. Also, I thought maybe I should shrink the chassis design just a bit so these cover up these weak points here. Because right here is where axes and other weapons can get through. Down here underneath it and on the side right here. So that's really not much, very exposed. And it's hard to get to those spots, although an out-of-control Havoc robot did break right through and kill this guy recently, but that's not going to be too common. So, we're not going to waste too much more time here. This is a great, fun mod. I'm almost ready to put out another Fight of the Week for Robot Arena 2014. But this is a great game. I enjoy it a lot. It's a lot of fun. I still cannot make any contact with anybody from Game Tech Mods on up, so... Oh well, I'll keep trying. So you guys have a fine week out there, good weekend, great day, and we'll see you soon for another battle. And if you have any requests, let me know. I'll pit this guy against anybody you can think of. That's in this mod, that is. Alright. Oh yeah, we were looking at 13 black to see how it was set up. To see if I could set the spider up with a similar configuration to this. I was just checking these controls out. You can't really manipulate these bots too much, tear them apart and put them back together. But they do provide a lot of information. And you can learn a lot by looking at them, how they were put together, and how they're built. Okay, I'm done. See you soon. Hey, welcome to Robot Wars, the new mod. Neat stuff. We're going to try something new today. We have been working on our machine on emergency. Let's go into arcade mode, and let's see, game settings, mayhem, tag team, arena, combat, robots, here we go, something really hairy, Thor, and we're given, what is team, what's the game have, okay, Tomb Raider, that looks interesting, this mouse team, okay, how about Mega Mouse, oh, Hellfire, sorry about that. And this Flamic, however you pronounce that, versus Emergency. And we've done a little bit of work on Emergency. It's not a super heavyweight, this tag is incorrect. It's under 80 kilograms, just barely, but under. We just did a little bit of work on the weapons pack. I noticed that the weapons were, a couple of them were turning in the wrong direction, causing the machine when it was inverted to spin. So we did a little work on that, and hopefully it's corrected. So without too much more hoorah, here we go. We'll use the F2 key to try to keep track of all the action. Two versus one, two super heavyweights versus one heavyweight. And I don't expect to win this, but this is a pretty good machine, so let's get started and see how Emergency performs in a 2-to-1 match. Outgunned, outweighed, but it's a very good machine. So here we go.
Enter the combat zone. Everyone hold on to your seats. This match is gonna blow you away. The saws and spikes are especially sharp. I've never felt such a cold chill as I've felt between the opposing bots this evening.
Three, two, one.
Purple these rebels.
That was something. Okay, just for fun, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the the machine itself. And so there's no questions here. Need to go to parts. And you can see just under 80 kilograms, heavyweight. And panic attack lid, motorcycle wheels. These little itty bitty covers. And these teeth, once you put them on, they're really almost impossible to get them back off. Anyway, we have carbon fiber extenders and amp blade. Use the amp blade to mount right here, the overdrive disc. Do the same thing with these amp blades here. They also, if the disc gets broke off, you still have the amp blade as a secondary weapon. Not much, but it's something. And for the drive wheels, we use the NTM brushless motors. The chassis is made of titanium. We have two of these batteries here, and one receiver, small receiver. And that's pretty much it. You see the weapons pack here. These guys, inertia style disc and teeth, and we have this big wedge in here. And there, of course, in reality, would be a couple of holes sliced in it right here for the spinners to work through, but that's no big deal. It's fairly realistic, almost completely. As you can see here, we mounted the fiberglass extender and these carbon extenders. Use these, this little guy right here, the mega adapter, to mount those on. And I'm still thinking of changing these out to maybe conserve some weight. Also, I thought maybe I should shrink the chassis design just a bit so these cover up these weak points here. Because right here is where axes and other weapons can get through, and, down here underneath it and on the side right here. So that's really not much, very exposed. And it's hard to get to those spots, although an out-of-control Havoc robot did break right through and kill this guy recently, but that's not going to be common. So, we're not going to waste too much more time here. This is a great, fun mod. I'm almost ready to put out another fight of the week for Robot Arena 2014. But this is a great game. I enjoy it a lot. It's a lot of fun. I still cannot make any contact with anybody from Game Tech Mods on up, so... Oh well, I'll keep trying. So you guys have a fine week out there, good weekend, great day, and we'll see you soon for another battle. And if you have any requests, let me know. I'll pit this guy against anybody you can think of. That's in this mod, that is. Alright. Oh yeah, we were looking at 13 black to see how it was set up. To see if I could set the spider up with a similar configuration to this. I was just checking these controls out. You can't really manipulate these bots too much to tear them apart and put them back together. But they do provide a lot of information. And you can learn a lot by looking at them, how they were put together, and how they're built. Okay, I'm done. See you soon.